moved past the outer courts into the holy place, past the brazen altar. Lord, I want to see your face. Pass me by the crowds of people, the priests who sing your praise. I hunger and thirst for your righteousness, but it's only found in one place. Take me into the holy of holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb. Take me into.
Unleash your God-given purpose. Get your heart right and live an abundant life. If you have your Bible, hold it up and say it with me. I am renewed, restored, and transformed. My heart is open, my mind is alert, I'm ready to receive in Jesus' name. Thank you so much for joining us today. I want to talk to you today about God's promises. If you turn with me to the book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 13, it says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Amazing. These powerful Bible verses demand we cast away our fears, be strong and courageous. Relying on God enables us to do this, allowing us to be more productive and to sacrifice for others. Love protects us from fear and makes us stronger. Simply opening the Bible and reading God's Word is a powerful way to overcome fears and obstacles in our lives. It's amazing when we finally realize that the Bible has stories that can relate to our everyday lives, and that we can implement His Word in our day-to-day interactions and situations. Watch this example in the book of Genesis, where Jacob is deceived by Laban.
Learn to explain how the Lord leads us as we learn to yield to Him. Jacob loved Rachel, even though he had only known her for a short time, when he said he would work for her for 7 years. In this topic, we will see that Laban deceived Jacob and gave Leah to Jacob, even though he had worked 7 years for Rachel. Apparently, Jacob went to work for Laban very soon after he arrived. After a month, Laban finally asked him what he wanted as wages for his work. Genesis 29:15 through 17 says, "Then Laban said to Jacob, 'Because you are my relative, should you therefore serve me for nothing? Tell me, what should your wages be?' Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the elder was Leah, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Leah's eyes were delicate, but Rachel was beautiful of form and appearance. Laban realized that it was not right to expect a relative to work for nothing. That is why after a month, Laban asked Jacob to tell him what he wanted for wages. Jacob had come for a wife, and Laban had two daughters. By this time, Jacob knew which daughter he wanted. Soon the 7 years had passed, and so Jacob said to Laban in Genesis 29:21-25, "Then Jacob said to Laban, 'Give me my wife, for my days are fulfilled, that I may go into her.' And Laban gathered together all the men of that place and made a feast. Now it came to pass in the evening that he took Leah his daughter and brought her to Jacob, and he went into her. And Laban gave his maid Zilpah to his daughter Leah as a maid. So it came to pass in the morning that, behold, it was Leah. And he said to Laban, 'What is this that you have done for me? Was it not for Rachel that I served you? Why have you deceived me?' Jacob was eager to marry Rachel as soon as he had completed the 7 years of work to receive her as his bride. As a result, he made the request to Laban for his wife to be given to him so he could marry her and go into her. Laban agreed and gathered all of the men of that place for a week of feasting to celebrate the wedding. That was the custom of that area. That evening, everything was ready for the marriage so that Jacob could receive his bride. However, Laban chose to deceive Jacob and brought Leah to Jacob instead of Rachel. Since the bride had a veil over her face and it was dark, Jacob could not see her face and realized that it was Leah instead of Rachel. As a result, he went into the tent in the dark of the night and consummated the marriage with her. It was not until the morning that Jacob learned that he had been deceived by Laban and that he was married to Leah instead of Rachel. Suddenly Jacob understood what it was like to be deceived instead of being the one who was the deceiver. He had deceived his brother more than 7 years earlier and had seen the great anger of his brother. At the same time, we see that Laban had done what was customary at a wedding. He had also given Zilpah to his daughter Leah as a maid. It was a custom in their culture for the father to give the daughter a maid to help the daughter. Of course, that did not ease the anger of Jacob, but Laban could see that he had carried out the customs of the culture. In his anger, Jacob went to Laban and asked him three questions. First, Jacob asked, "What is this that you have done to me?" Jacob had worked for 7 years to pay for his wife. Those years had seemed like just a few days because of the love Jacob had for Rachel. However, he realized that Laban had tricked him and that he was now married to Leah instead. This was not the woman for whom he had worked those 7 years. Instead, this was the older sister, not the young woman Jacob had loved and eagerly looked forward to marrying. Jacob suddenly knew what it felt like to be cheated. Second, Jacob asked, "Was it not for Rachel that I served you?" Jacob had said in Genesis 29:18, "Now Jacob loved Rachel, so he said, 'I will serve you 7 years for Rachel, your younger daughter.'" Jacob had made it clear to Laban that it was Rachel that he had wanted to marry. He had specifically said that he wanted to marry the younger daughter. Of course, Laban knew what Jacob had said, but due to the fact that Leah's eyes were delicate, he knew that it was possible no one would ask to marry her. In fact, in the next topic, we will see that Laban had already planned to give Rachel to Jacob, but he was going to get 7 additional years of work from Jacob for Rachel. Third, Jacob asked, "Why then have you deceived me?" Jacob understood what it meant to deceive others. He had deceived his father to get the blessing. He had deceived his brother by claiming to be Esau, so his father would give him the blessing. Now he had been deceived and knew how it felt to be deceived. He had worked for Rachel for 7 years, and then after the marriage found out that he was married to Leah and that his father-in-law had deceived him. The Lord later led Paul to write in Galatians 6:7, "Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap." Jacob had reaped exactly as he had sown. We want to help our physical and spiritual children understand and apply these verses to their own lives so they will be able to help others realize the consequences of their choices. Many people fail to realize that they will reap the consequences of their choices. That is why it is so clearly explained what happens when people make sinful choices.
We see here that Jacob now understands what it feels like to be deceived after he had deceived others. Here's one story. Or how about the story of Abraham and Sarah? Not only does this story teach us patience, it also teaches us to have faith. The story of Abraham and Sarah shares a commonality with every one of us. I believe that probably each one of us knows what it is like to desire something for our lives in the deepest parts of our heart. And though it seems difficult sometimes, we also have had to adopt an attitude of prayer and faithfulness as we wait on God's answer, just like Abraham and Sarah. Sometimes it's an eventual answer to a prayer, yet other times it's a different miracle and a different story for our lives that ends up being better than we could have ever imagined. God is always working. He never stops. And as we wait patiently and faithfully in prayer, and in praise, patiently exercising our gratitude muscle, even if we don't have an answer yet. God is already working in this as He transforms our hearts. Remain thankful, worship His holy name, and He will turn it around, and He will provide a blessing. If you know the story, you'll see that Sarah was childless until she was 90 years old. The point here is God promised Abraham that his wife would be a mother of nations, according to Genesis 17, verse 16, and that she would conceive and bear a son, but Sarah didn't believe this. But guess what? Isaac was born to Sarah and Abraham at their old age, and this was a fulfillment of God's promise to them. Don't let anyone tell you he can't or he won't. Keep your faith. Trust His word, because I already know that He wants to, and He will. He's done it before, and I can assure you he will do it again. Pray with me. Open my ears, God, to hear your voice speaking to me from Scripture today. I don't want to just settle for easy answers. I don't want to just read the Bible in a way that makes me feel good. I want to give you continual, constant permission to interrupt and rearrange my life. Give me a passion as I read to take seriously the truth of what I'm reading. Help me resist the temptation to put your words into my heart without letting them change my heart and my actions. I confess that knowledge about you isn't enough. I need life transformation. Please show me how the Scripture is meant to transform the way I inhabit my world. In Jesus' name, amen.
In the darkness, we were waiting without hope, without light, till from heaven you came running. There was mercy in your eyes to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the
and the dead rose from their tombs.